The opening text states that the term Sisu is Finnish and has no direct translation but is essentially a force of unstoppable determination that comes out when most necessary. A narrator then starts by stating that it is 3 years into World War II, 1944. Finland has agreed to an armistice with the Soviet Union to drive German troops out of their country. The Nazis have begun to employ scorched earth tactics, destroying towns, roads, and bridges and capturing people. Chapter 1: The Gold. In Lapland, a prospector named Atami Korpi is with his little dog in an area mining for gold. He finds a little gold nugget and camps in the area over a few nights while enemy planes fly overhead. Eventually, Atami manages to find a plentiful gold deposit in the dirt, causing him to cheer. He gathers his gold and starts to make his way to the nearest bank. Chapter 2: The Nazis. A Nazi platoon led by Bruno Heldorf makes its way through the land, taking with them a group of women as their prisoners. A small group of Nazis encounters Atami and the dog while he rides on his horse. They stop him and demand to inspect his belongings. Atami sends the dog to run away and hide while the Nazis start shooting at him. The lead Nazi finds Atami's gold and starts to taunt him, saying he and the others will take it. Atami responds by grabbing a knife and sticking it in the Nazi's head. He then proceeds to stab and shoot the remaining Nazis, including using one as a human shield. Atami proceeds on the horse. Heldorf and his goons find their comrades' corpses and a gold rock that was left behind. They follow Atami's trail and begin to shoot at him. The horse manages to outrun the gunfire, but they run over a mine, and the horse is blown to bits. Atami mourns his horse before having to hide. Chapter 3: The Minefield. Heldorf and the other Nazis find Atami and corner him. He spots a nearby mine and throws a rock at it, creating an explosion that helps hide him. The Nazis starts to open fire in his direction. Heldorf sends a young Nazi out to see if Atami is still alive. Atami throws a minefield at the Nazi's head, blowing him up. Heldorf sends two more men out to run, forcing them to run into mines and get blown up as well. The Nazis continue their gunfire, which Atami blocks with a shield. One of the female prisoners, Eino, volunteers to go up ahead along with a second woman. Chapter 4: The Legend. As the Nazis proceed forward, Heldorf talks to one of his mates that found Atami's dog tags, and who knows about Atami and his history of serving in the Winter War. He lost his family to the Russians, and he has since earned a reputation for being a ruthless killing machine that some have taken to calling Kashe, the Immortal. Heldorf intends to get the gold because he knows that the Nazi party will soon lose its power, and the gold will be their way to retire in peace. Atami runs and hides until the Nazi convoy drives past, and he rolls under one of their vans. He cuts one of the gas lines to mask his scent from the Nazis' attack dogs. Heldorf and the others stop when they smell the gas. They catch Atami and try to kill him, but he sparks a match that ignites the gas he is covered in, setting himself on fire until he runs into a nearby lake. The Nazis shoot at him, but Heldorf waits for him to come up for air. He then sends three Nazis on a boat to dive in after him. Two men dive in, and Atami slits their throats and takes their remaining air. The third man starts to ride the boat away, but Heldorf has him shot for trying to desert them. Atami gets on the boat and escapes, but Heldorf gets the dog. Chapter 5: Scorched Earth. Atami comes upon a town devastated by the Nazis' tactics. He finds an abandoned gas station where Heldorf sends the dog to run to his master, with a stick of dynamite attached to him. Atami removes the dynamite but gets thrown by the explosion. Heldorf, plus his two goons Wolf and Schutz, show up and tie Atami up by the neck to hang him before stealing the rest of his gold. Atami manages to hook one of his wounds from the explosion onto a nearby pole to save himself from the noose. The following morning, a pair of German pilots come by to get fuel. They find Atami and attempt to antagonize him, but Atami stabs one to death and knocks the other unconscious. When he comes to, Atami makes him fly him closer to the platoon before hanging him and leaving him for the Nazis to find. Chapter 6, Kill 'Em All. Atami catches up to the convoy as they head toward Norway to make their escape with the gold. He gets a hold of some guns and gives them to Eino and the other women. Atami pulls one Nazi out onto the street, where he gets run over by a tank. The women then arm themselves and pump the Nazis full of lead. Atami commandeers a tank and pulls Wolf out, leaving him to be taken by the women. Heldorf and Schutz meet with their pilot to get them out, but Heldorf shoots Schutz in the head and leaves with the pilot himself. Atami catches up to them and shoots at them with the tank, hitting the pilot. Atami then uses his pickaxe to hook himself onto the plane as it takes off. He breaks his way inside, with Heldorf confronting him. He starts to beat Atami ferociously, even using a static line to slice into his face. However, Atami waits for the right moment to grab the line and hook it onto a nearby bomb, dropping it from the plane with Heldorf attached to it, sending him plummeting to his explosive death. Atami then goes into the cockpit where the pilot has died, and he braces for impact as the plane crashes. Final chapter. Eino and the other imprisoned women deliver Wolf to the Finnish army. Meanwhile, Atami pulls himself out of a swamp and finds a motorcycle, also reuniting with the dog in the process. Atami rides to Helsinki, where he arrives at a bank. Everyone stares at the filth-covered prospector entering with his pickaxe. He takes the recovered gold to a teller and dumps it all on the counter. Atami finally speaks, requesting large bills because they won't be such a bitch to carry.